I obviously didn't want to go back and see it. I didn't want to go get the x-rays or whatever it was. I wanted just to continue to play. I told him I would do it at halftime, coach, I mean, in the best interest of me, he made me go back there and get that x-ray before he put me back in the game. And for a while, I thought I could get and play through it, and then he said, I'm not putting you back in, so you might as well go get the x-ray, and then if it's negative or whatever, I'll put you back in. So I ran back there, got the x-ray, and was able to play, finish the game.
How are you feeling now?
I was just talking to him. It feels better. I mean, it feels better than I thought it was going to be now. Obviously, I have a lot of adrenaline going right now, so we'll see how it feels. But I'll hop right in the treatment tonight and try to do whatever I can to be as close to 100% by next week. But luckily for us, we played the early game on Saturday, so we get an extra almost half a day that I can let that ankle rest.
Knowing you didn't want to come out, what did you make of the job Chad
did? I mean, it's special, man. He's in the playoffs. He doesn't get any reps during the week. And he prepares himself to be able to go in for stuff like that. And he got a 98-yard drive, backed up, a playoff game against a great opponent, and to be able to drive the ball down the field, make some big throws versus some pressure looks. I mean, they brought some heat whenever he came in the game. And he made some big throws and was able to get us into the end zone. And that was a big point in the game because it was able to – that gave me the ability to kind of come back and rest and wait till halftime until we kind of retaped and did everything we could to get me ready to go in the second half. No, nothing. I mean, no real treatment. You don't have time to get treatment and stuff like that. But, I mean, you just put the spat on, get it tight, try to keep the swelling down, and then go out there and play. And they made me do a couple things in the locker room to show that I could move and protect myself if everything kind of came, pressure came, whatever it was. And, I mean, credit to the team. Offensive line did a great job in the second half of protecting me. I got the ball in my hands quickly, and guys made plays. But it's a team sport for a reason, and guys stepped up around me.
Mm-hmm. Was that conscious or it just jumping off the other foot and all those things? How do you process that?
Yeah, you just got to be a competitor at the end of the day. I mean, not all things are going to be perfect. You have to find a way to make stuff happen. Obviously, I missed some throws I probably think I could have made if I would have been in the right foot position. But luckily for me, I'm not in the right foot position all the time, so I'm able to make some throws like that anyways.
Patrick, I know you have a high tolerance for pain. How much more are you able to take? And then, did you ever feel like you might have –
I mean, I'm not coming out of a playoff game unless they take me out. And so I'm just going to play. I love this sport too much. I love this game. I love playing with my teammates and being able to go out there and enjoy it together. And we prepare all year to be in the playoffs and to play in these games. And I'm glad that I was able to get back in the game. And, I mean, it's something that I just love competing in this sport. And pain is pain, and you don't have to deal with it either way.
And it seems to set a number. This is your fifth straight answer to the round thing. Any quarterback in the history of the league has played consecutively in that many since they've been a starter. What's that mean for you in this organization?
Yeah, I mean, it's a credit to the team I have around me, the coaches I have around me, and the organization in general. I mean, we prepare ourselves every year from training camp in St. Joe's, Missouri, to be here. But it takes a day-by-day process, and I think the coaches preach that, the players do that, and the organization around us supports us in that mission. And so we just try to do whatever we can to be in this position to get to this AFC Championship game, and then now we'll find a way to get to the Super Bowl, and that's going to take a great week of preparation and practice.
You touched on this a minute ago, but how much do you feel like the injury affected you in the second half?
There was just a couple throws here and there where I tried to plant off that foot, and it didn't let me kind of plant like I usually do. And so a couple throws I didn't make. I told Coach I want to still throw it downfield, and so we were able to make some throws there after the first few drives, and I think he got a little confidence that I could protect myself. Credit to our defense, man, holding us in that game, especially after the start of that second half when I wasn't able to get stuff going. So they held us in that game, made some big plays at the end, and we were able to score enough points to win. Yeah, very. I mean, pretty nervous moments, man. I mean, I always pray whenever stuff like that comes around, man. And just it's all in God's hands at the end of the day, and I just have to accept whatever it is and turn it into a positive. And so, luckily for me, he blessed me to keep me injury free, as far as breaks or anything like that. And so now, how can I prepare my body to be ready to go next week? And I'll start that tonight, and that process will be tough, but I'll be ready to go.
Is that the game on TV for you?
I'll be watching the game for sure. I mean, playoff football is the best time of the year, man. Just to be able to watch that, and so I'll get the treatment and stuff like that. But the family's gonna have to wait for a while because I'll be getting that stuff done.
You know, I meant today when you were getting the
X-ray. Oh no, they don't ever show the TV, man. I've been back there. The divisional round, whenever the Browns game when Chad was playing, I didn't get to see like any of that until like the last drive. And so they do a good job of not having the TVs going in there, so that I have to focus on myself and getting myself better more than focusing on the game.
Couple more.
We have 14 receptions, 2 touchdowns. What do you think of his day?
Yeah, man, it's another guy just steps up, man. It seems like he gets better and better in the playoffs as you get further and further in there. And you need those type of guys, and he did a great job of making some tough contested catches. He's special, man. He's a special player, a one-of-a-kind player. That's one of the main reasons that we've been able to be in this position so many times.
What's it like being
Yeah, no, it was a good job by everybody. I think everybody had a part in that drive. Everybody was making plays. And that's what championship teams do, is that whenever stuff's not going their way and the game gets tight, how are you going to respond? And I went down, I kind of jumped and landed on the same ankle, but I had to find a way to get the ball in the end zone, and Marquez was there, and I needed to make the throw. And he stepped up, made a big play there at the end of the game to win it.
Last two, Neil and Bobby.
75,000 people thought this was going to be an easy game. What was it like being in a tight game with your situation with your ankle and with knowing your season's on the line?
Yeah, I mean, I never think any playoff game is going to be easy. I mean, teams are here for a reason. And even if they are surprised in a sense or whatever it is, they're here for a reason. They have the confidence that it's going to be a great game. If you look at Wild Card Weekend or really the playoffs in general the last few years, every game seems like it's a one-score game. We came with the mentality that we were going to have to play until the very end. And obviously we had some adversity through there with some injuries and stuff like that. But I was proud of how the guys responded and were able to figure out a way to get the win.
Hard to separate, but how much do you feel like your urgency to get back in was I gotta play, and how much as a single to your teammates, like, you know, galvanize them?
Yeah, I mean, obviously you want to play. I mean, you just want to play because you've built that time from St. Joe. You've spent this time with your teammates and built up for this moment, and so you don't want to let guys down or whatever it is. You want to be in the game and be able to go out there and show off what you've worked for. But I don't think it really was anything for the team, because the team has so much belief in Chad, and he's done it before. He's won divisional games by coming in and playing. And so they had so much belief in Chad, and you saw in that 98-yard drive. He ran the offense the way the offense was supposed to be ran. He threw it to the right guys, and guys stepped up and made plays. That's what a great team does. It's not about one guy. It's about the whole team.
Great. Hey.